Be very careful in the presence of Jehovah.
Hallelujah.
Now, quickly this month of September, Sam, play something very slowly. I believe that the Holy Ghost is going to move in this place in a dimension like never seen before in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The way you answer amen, I know if you believe or not. This month of September is declared our month of fruitfulness and divine direction.
Amen.
Someone told me this week, after we crossed that line, and we said that some people will die. After you said that, the number two person went. The strong man went. Another one is gone. Another one is gone. Another one is gone. That's what I just said. Someone said to me that two of her relatives, that when they were kids, they used to run. You know when you see a witch who is really a witch, a strong man who is really trying to kill everyone in the family. She said that when they see them on the road, she will go her own way. She said to me that by the prayers at Word and Fire Ministry, the two of them are gone.
Amen.
I prophesy that whoever has vowed, hallelujah,
amen,
that you will not move forward, no matter their rank, no matter their level, no matter their office, no matter their area in the supernatural, after this encounter, they must go for your sake in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
I said they will confess and die for your sake in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You may be seated. Some of us don't like what I'm saying now.
Amen.
Until you begin, God begins to open your eyes to begin to see your history, to begin to know that the people you used to eat with are the people who want you there. I remember when I was at university, back home in Cameroon, before I came here for university, I had an uncle. My God, you will go to him, he will cook for you, he will give you food, he will so pet you. No thought in your head that he's the one killing you. That every time he's preparing that food, he's putting something there. When I became born again, all of us became born again, and God began to show us. Say, look at this person you used to eat with. Look at this person who used to give you money. Before he gave us money to go to university, you go and put it in the coffin. Jesus said, pray for your enemies. But he did not give you prayer points. That means that you have the capacity and the right to pray for them the way you want to pray for them. You guys don't like this. I know you don't like this. You know, an ant can beat you, sir. You are the only one who is legally authorized to tell me how it hurts.
Yes.
Does that make sense?
Amen.
I might only be there telling you, I'm sorry. Is it too painful? I will not know exactly what you're going through.
Amen.
Until I am placed in your shoe. Yes. That is when I'll be able to know.
Yes.
That the violent taken it by force. Every word from the Bible is strategic. From the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God, what's the kingdom of God? This kingdom is suffering violent, but only the violent take it by force. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So if you are too casual, you might end up a casualty. No one here will end up a casualty in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
We say this is a month of fruitfulness, fruitfulness in every area of our life. But fulfilling this declaration in my life begins with a dream and a die-hearted passion for God. You don't understand. Why am I saying that? A die-hearted passion for God. Lord, whether there is food on my table, I love you more. Lord, whether there is money in my bank account, I want to know you more. A die-hearted passion for God. I'm saying that because many know where God has told them to go. Many, they know that God has given them a business to start. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they end up not pursuing it. Why? Because they don't have a die-hearted passion for God. Notice that Joseph did not just have a dream. Joseph did not just have a vision. But he also had a die-hearted passion for God to fulfill that dream. So it is one thing to have a dream. It is another thing to fulfill that dream. It is one thing for a woman to be pregnant. It is another thing for that woman to bring forth her child. So it is what you do now that determines what comes to you tomorrow.
Amen.
It is what you do now that determines what you recover tomorrow. It is what you do now that determines what your destiny is going to look like. I am here to make a declaration that anyone that has shot an arrow against your prayer life. Instead of praying for 2 hours, the next day you pray for 5 minutes, the next day you pray for 4 minutes. That is not consistent. Hallelujah. That is not consistent. I release in this service the consistency for prayer in the name of Jesus. After now, it will be said of you that the more you pray, the more you want to pray more in the name of Jesus. I say, after now, it will be said of you that the more you pray in tongues, the more you want to pray in tongues in the name of Jesus. That amen is from Ghana. That one is from Douala. That one is from Congo. That is why, even in prison, Joseph fulfilled his dreams. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Friends, I all want you to know today that life will not sympathize with you. And so you must make up your mind and say, enough is enough. This going to and fro, this going 1-2 step and going back 3 steps, it must end. For the kingdom of God suffered violence, and I must take what belongs to me by force. So regardless of where you are today, regardless of what you are facing right now, I want you to make up your mind in this service that you will not give up on anything that God has placed in your heart. I want you to make up your mind in this service that that problem will give up. I will not give up. That problem must be the one to give up. I came today by the power of the Holy Ghost to ignite your passion for that great dream in the name of Jesus. I say that business will rise again in the name of Jesus. I say that career will rise again in the name of Jesus. I say that application that you are still looking forward to, they will call you this week in the name of Jesus. Now, like I said, it is important to know that there are some principles we must follow in order to be fruitful on every side and be redirected like Simon. Remember, Simon, they fish all night. They fish all night, nothing. Can you imagine someone the whole night? They have labored. They have labored. No one fish. It's like that day the fish, they held a prayer meeting and they said, let's not go where Simon is coming. Let's go to the other side. So all what Simon was doing is toiling all night, and they caught no fish. But what happened? When Christ came on the scene, sir, the story was different.
Oh, yeah.
The Bible says they had a net catching. The fish were too much until their net break. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said the fish were too much, their net break. Jesus came on the scene and said, Simon, redirect the boat. Redirect the boat. In this service, God will be redirecting your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Quickly, because we have 20 more minutes, the very first and the most important is to increase your hunger for the master. Go need to Luke 19:1. Luke 19:1, we shall read together from Luke 19:1. Are we there? I'll read verse 1, read verse 2, and then we'll read verse 19 together. Let's read without understanding. Verse 1 says, and Jesus entered and passed through Jericho. Read verse 2, please.
And behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among
them. Let your voices sound like thunder. Let the devil be afraid now. Read with power.
And behold, there was a man named Zacchaeus, which was the chief among the publicans, and he was rich.
Okay, I read verse 3. Verse 3 says, and he sought to see Jesus, who he was, and could not for the press. So even in those days, there was a press. The press has been in stopping people all along because he was little of stature. Read verse 4, please.
And he ran before and climbed up onto the sycamore tree to see him, for he was to pass that way.
I read verse 5. It says, and when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said unto him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must abide at the house. Read verse 7, please. Verse 6.
And he made haste and came down and received him joyfully.
Verse 7 says, and when they saw it, they all murmured, saying that he was gone to be guest with a man that is a sinner. Verse 8, please.
And Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore him fourfold.
Verse. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house, for so much as he also is the son of Abraham. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at Zacchaeus there, who was very rich. Zacchaeus had everything in gold, in silver, in coins. But still, Zacchaeus knew that something was missing to complete him. And that thing was the presence of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at every great man in the Bible that made him a decision. Life did not begin in the life of Jacob until he had an encounter with God. Because before that, he was so broke. Life did not begin in the life of Abraham until he had an encounter with God. Before that, he could not even pay house rent. He was living with his parents, with his wife and everybody. Life did not begin in the life of Moses until he met God in the burning bush.
Amen.
So for us to move to that place that God has ordained for us, we must constantly dwell in the presence of the Lord. Go with me to Luke 11, Luke 12, 15 to 22. We shall read together. Luke 12, 15 to 22. Luke 12, 15 to 22. Verse 15 says, and he said unto them, take heed and keep yourself from all covetousness, for a man's life consisted not in the abundance of the things which he possessed. Oh, read the next verse, please. Verse 16.
And he spake a parable unto them, saying, the ground of a certain rich man brought forth plenty.
Let's read together verse 17. And he thought within himself, saying, what shall I do? Because I have no room where to bestow my fruits. Verse 18, please. And he said, this will I do. I will pull down my barns and build greater, and there will I bestow all my fruits and my goods. Verse 19, let's read together. And I will say to my soul, soul, thou art much goods. Lay up from many years, take thou eat, drink, and be merry. Verse 20, please. And he says, verse 20. Then God said unto him, thou fool, this night thy soul shall be required of thee. Then whose shall those things be which thou hast provided? Many are not in church today because they are chasing money. What shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Many today, especially in Africa, they join courts and they kill their children. In fact, some of them have one and they'll still kill that one for money. Who now will eat the money? And at one point, because they have no one else to give, they give themselves. So all the labor in the court in vain. Many think that once they are born again, that guarantees them making heaven. And so they remain at the same level with no personal encounter with God, without dwelling in the presence of God. That is why in church today, you see so many broke Christians, because God is not a respecter of person. God is a respecter of principles. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why many people, you go and preach to them, they say, why are you telling me? What? They'll look at you first. Hallelujah. They'll look at your life first. If they cannot see a change in you, I don't see why you want me to know the God that is in you. Does that make sense? Why would someone go to heavenlies and you see where they are sitting, so dirty, so nasty, nothing to show for, and you think that they themselves, they will give you riches that they don't have? That is an error that needs to be corrected.
Oh, yeah.
I prophesy that anyone that has gone to a heavenlies with your face, with your picture, by this encounter, I command them, let them be paralyzed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That mouth that they used to call your name, after now, that mouth is paralyzed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That eye that they used to look at that point, after now, I command that eye be blinded in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I was telling someone the other day not to get satisfied where they were, because there is more to God than just being born again and attending church every Sunday. There is more to God than just coming here on Sunday and going back home, forgetting your Bible, forgetting your fellowship with God, forgetting your relationship with God. In the verses that we read, it says that until he had an encounter. Zacchaeus knew that although I have all this money, but until I have an encounter with the God who created the heavens and the earth, nothing will really change my life. Zacchaeus, he was loaded more than the others around him. But he said, whatever happens, no matter the price, I must climb a tree. I must see that Jesus. I must have a personal encounter with this Jesus that changes story. Isaiah 43:19. It says, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the deserts.
Amen.
So what should we take that verse and we are praying all night? Who is that verse talking about? Those who constantly dwell in his presence.
Oh yes.
Those who are constantly dwelling in the presence of the Lord. I said to this gentleman, I said, stop celebrating the same testimony every time. I see you beg hunger and thirst to know more of God, because even criminals celebrate testimonies.
Amen.
Does that make sense, sir?
Oh, yeah.
The fact that a man is in the presence of God, and on Sunday, and they have a testimony they are sharing, it does not mean that they have divine approval. The only guarantee of divine approval is constantly dwelling in the presence of God. He said in his word that those who must follow me, they must take up their cross and follow me daily. Sir, not some days. Not today and Wednesday. Not today and Thursday. Daily means daily. As busy as I am this morning, I read at least 5 chapters. Daily. They must follow me daily. From the verses we just read, that tells you the blessings of God is not the approval of God. That tells you that the mercies of God is not the approval of God. God is ready to do a new thing, but many Christians are not ready to walk into the next level of blessings. They are celebrating the same testimonies every day. God is blessing a man. It does not necessarily mean that God is with that man. Does that make sense?
No.
Some places you go, you see miracles. It does not mean that God is there. Does that make sense?
No, yes.
I cannot come to you and say, be healed, and you're healed. And then you see me with one girl in one corner. And, and then, hallelujah.
Amen.
None yet shall fail in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is blessing the man. When God is blessing the man, it does not mean that God is with that man. Go with me to Genesis 20:17. Let me read the verse. Genesis 20:17. It said, then Abraham prayed to God, and God healed Abimelech, his wife, his family, his slaves, so they could have children again. Okay, that's very confusing now. Because that same Abraham was the one that lied before those verses. Does that make sense? The same Abraham lied. And for a man to lie and he was dead, after he lied, he went and healed everyone in that family. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Does that mean that God was happy with the lie? No. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the fact that there are miracles, there are breakthroughs, does not mean that God is necessarily with that particular person. He says, Abraham, I said, I will pray for you and your household will be healed. So that tells you that even having the healing anointing is not an approval that God is with you. Does that make sense, sir?
Oh, yes.
Even having the healing anointing is not an approval that God is with a man. Abraham lied and was blessed mightily and was still used by God to be a blessing to others. Today, many are in church living a worldly life, a life of deceit. I told you one day that I met a minister. Then everything he says is a lie. If everything was just irritating me. Everyone is like, it's like conviction. As soon as he say one thing, the Holy Ghost tell me, that's a lie again. As soon as he say another one, the Holy Ghost tell me, that's a lie again. That God is with a man does not mean that God approves of what the man is doing. And for your understanding, worldliness in this sense does not only mean stealing, or clubbing, or telling lies, or drinking alcohol. If you are proud, you are worldly. Does that make sense? If you are proud, you are worldly. If you are watching the dramas we see on TV, those dramas where they just orchestrate things, They call them the big brothers, all those things. Big, I used to watch them about many years ago. I was staying up at 2 a.m. watching a program that does not glorify my spirit. That's worriness in a sense. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go need to test John 2, 15, 17. It says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but it is of the world. It says in verse 17, and the world passed away, and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abided with him forever. What is the will of God? Fellowship with God. Praying is the will of God. Hallelujah. Reading the Bible is the will of God. Dwelling in the presence is the will of God. So the only way out of worldliness is a hunger, is a thirst for the Father, is the thirst for the love for the Father. I was thanking God for something the other week, and he said to me that I should forget that testimony because he does not remember the former things. It is something, the testimony that someone gave him, and I was thanking God. I said, God, thank you for that testimony. I said, yeah, I don't remember that. Say, as far as heaven is concerned, there's no more record of that. I said, Lord, why? He said, because I'm doing a new thing. And he said, why? Because the testimonies, he did them. I did not do them. Does that make sense?
Oh, yes.
He performed the testimony. I did not perform the testimony. So I cannot be thanking him for what he did. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many are in church, like I said, still celebrating and focusing on things that heaven has already forgotten. Friends, what God looks at daily is your walk with him, your hunger for more of him. Many ministers and even Christians today are focusing on the crowd in churches. But God told me that I do not focus on the size of a ministry, but I will judge you based on your daily walk with me, your personal daily walk with me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, I cannot judge on the crowd because I bring the crowd. Nobody brings them in except I, God, brings them in. You are not here because I invited you. You are here because your steps were ordained and orchestrated by Jehovah Jireh.
Oh, yes.
See, what I focus on is your daily walk with me. Not the abundance, not the crowd, not the wealth, not the riches, but your daily walk with me. He said, the crowd is what I got gathered, and I will not remember that because I brought them all in. He said, what I remember is what you do, son, and not what I did for the church. Now, a few years ago, he laid in my hand, I had, and he said, build me a church in Cameroon. This one is not, it's standing too much. Let me see, it's not standing. Then he says, build me a 3,000 capacity in Cameroon. And he said, do you believe that will be done? I said, God, I know it will be done. He said, I will not judge you still on that because I will bring it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God is not focused on what you see around you. God is focused on your walk with him. Testimonies are good, but we need to focus not on them because God is the author of them all. And as far as heaven is concerned, they are already erased from the record. I decree upon everyone hearing the sound of my voice, in the name above every other name, the remainder of this year 2017, you must be fruitful in every area of your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say you must be fruitful in every area of your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
John 10:10 says he came that we may have life and have it in abundance. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I declare, anything in you that does not speak of life in abundance, let an angel correct it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
Look at those verses again. Zacchaeus, from our verses, he knew that for him to be complete, he needed a personal encounter with Jesus. Today, we live in a self-centered, I call it Big Brother's society, where many Christians only serve God because of what they want to get from him. Many Christians only come to church because of what they want to get from God. Truly, this is the reason why many are so talented in church but yet jobless. Because of their insecurities. Some will ask for money in church before they cook food. It means you're only here to collect what you want to collect. You don't understand what I'm saying? It's like we have an occasion tomorrow, and someone will say, for me to cook all that food, you will pay for all the ingredients and everything we need, and you will still pay me to cook the food. Is that not being in church because you want to get? And they'll still eat that food though. In fact, they'll be the first to test, then they'll keep some aside for later, and then they'll come to church and still eat what is in church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those are people who are only there to collect what they can collect. It's like telling God, God, before I cook for your people, I need to be paid. And you wonder why their testimonies are delayed. That's the problem. That's the revelation I got since about 5 years ago in my previous where I was. No one here shall be a victim of delay in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Psalms 37 to the verse says, I've been young and now I am old. Yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. But look at the rich man there who had everything and still wanted more of the master. So I keep saying that before I became like I started going all out for God. I was doing two jobs. And those two jobs, my wife was even working sometimes part time. The life we're living now, from the time I became full time, is more than the life we're living there. No, seek first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all the other things that others are rushing after will be given to you. Became born again, so I was selling cars. Before I was selling one car, profit zero. Sometimes I only make £100 out of the car. But now I'm just going around my life. This month alone, I cannot count the number of cars I sold.
Hallelujah.
By the grace of God.
Amen.
And
Amen.
What people are rushing every day looking for, I just sit. They bring the cars to me.
Amen.
I tell them to drop it at the garage. If there's a problem, they sort it out. And then I just receive customers. They come and buy. This month alone, not less than £5,000 profit.
Amen.
Seek first the kingdom, everything you are rushing after, until you begin to say, oh, why am I saying that? You don't understand. The whole night, my head is down, praying. Then it's a day, I make calls, the cars comes, I give them to the garage, they sort them out. I receive. Sometimes a cow does not even spend 2 hours, it's sold. Why? Because a man has made up his mind that I will not rest until my encounter with God is daily. My encounter with God is consistent. My encounter with God, if a day passing me by, so I would not pray for 5 hours. That day I feel like I've lost that day. If a day passes me by without reading at least 5 chapters, that day I feel like I've lost that day. Last Sunday I read 10 chapters by the grace of God. Today I read 5, and I still felt like when I went to pick some of you, I said in the car, I said, God, Holy Ghost, I need just 5 minutes with you again. Hunger, thirst for the things of God, hunger for his presence, hunger for a change of story. God, they must not come back here and live the same. God, they must not come back here and live without sickness, and live without pain, and live without affliction. There must be a change of story. Heaven cannot see where he is and looks at a man like that and leaves him alone. Heaven will be in a hurry to bless that man. I pray in the name of Jesus, receive now the grace for his presence in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
The Bible says that Zacchaeus, pardon me, expressed his hunger for more of Jesus by leaving his friends to meet with Jesus. Is that what he says? He says he was with his friends, but as soon as he saw Jesus coming, he said, my friends, oh yeah, Papa, I need to meet with the master. I need to have a change of story. I need to have an encounter with this Jesus I have been hearing about. Some of us, our friends don't even know we are born again. Some of us, when they talk about the Bible at work, we scare away. And Jesus is always standing there looking at that one that will say, oh, I love my Jesus, and begin to proclaim the good news to the friends, to the brothers, to the neighbors. Some of us, our neighbors do not even know that we go to church. This is how we keep in the morning. We enter the car and go to church. We've never preached to them once. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says that if you are ashamed of me before men, what will happen? I would be ashamed of you before my Father who is in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Vanity upon vanity. Money is vanity. The Bible says that money, that those who are going after money, that money, when it comes into their hands, it flies with wings. I told someone another day, I said, you come to church today, the next time we'll see you 6 months, and you wonder why you don't have anything in your account. And you walk every day. Hallelujah. And you walk every day. Friends, when you meet him in his presence, every other thing comes naturally.
Oh, yes.
Naturally. Oh, yes. But it takes time. Like I told you, about 5 years ago, I was selling cars. To sell one was a problem. Hallelujah.
Amen.
After now, as you go after God with all your heart, there will be a change of story in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
Many are in church, but they are still in the world. This is how your friends will meet you, and they are saying silly things, and you're not saying anything. They are not scared to talk in front of you. Mm-hmm. Some of them will even be smoking their cigarette and blowing it in your face.
Jesus.
Because they know that your father, they are just pretending. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says that we are in this world, but not of this world. You are, Pastor, we are not the same. Does that make sense, sir? You are not the same with someone in the world. As far as I'm concerned, if you don't know Jesus for real, you're under my feet. I cannot envy any unbeliever. There is nothing like racism as far as God is concerned. Because if you seek His presence, before you get there, they'll say, we're waiting for you. We're waiting for you. We're waiting for you. You sit in your house as you are praising God, as you are waiting on Him, what will happen? That husband will knock that door. That wife will knock that door. That job that you'll be looking for, it will be rushing to you.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Remember once I applied for a job, I did not apply for a job, I just, have you not heard me as well? No application. Protocol was broken. Our sister said last week that they are, what she was saying last week, literally, she applied for nursing. Nursing is not kwa kwa kwa. I applied for pharmacy once. It's not kwa kwa kwa. When you don't have the requirements, nobody takes you. But what happened? Protocols were broken for her sake. I don't know what you are still waiting for. I don't know what you are still trusting God for. After this encounter, protocols will be broken for your sake in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Philippians 3:10 says that I may know Him and the power of His resurrection and the fellowship of His suffering being made conformable unto His death. Zacchaeus was following Jesus for what he could get from Jesus. But who Jesus was? Zacchaeus was not following Jesus for what he could get from Jesus. But Zacchaeus followed Jesus because he wanted to know more of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Bible says he was really rich. He was loaded. So he didn't need any money from Jesus. In fact, as a matter of fact, in those days they said Jesus was broke. They remember they said Jesus was broke. They said, look at him, he's broke. It makes you wonder, a broke man has a financial secretary. So what would a financial secretary be doing? A broke man who goes into a ship and he has a pillow. Who has a pillow in a plane? It's a person who is in a VIP. When you understand that, you know, nobody gives you a pillow. You either use your jacket to put your head there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today in this big brother's hotel,